Hey Crafty Friends, it's Christina. Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be having a little bit of fun with some pad and paper and making a Halloween card. I mentioned in my last video where I made a Halloween card that I've been a little inspired to make them. So we are going to be doing that. I'm using the Echo Park Spooktacular Halloween. I believe this is a newer, I bought one or two new things and I think this is one of the newer ones. And I have this pulled out and it's got some really adorable, papers in here that are super cute. I did go ahead and pull out two that I'm going to be using in today's card. I also have the Simon Says Stamp Hello or Halloween Friends along with the coordinating dies. Pulled out my trusty stitched rectangle die set that I use all the time, or haven't used actually in a while, but used to use it all the time. And then I have some glitter cardstock and some white, well, this is my card base. I have the Fog, Spellbinder's Fog, and then this is Spellbinder's Barely Peach cardstock. And I thought that peach cardstock matched nicely with this little peachy kind of color that's inside of this pattern paper. So we're going to start off with doing some stamping. I pulled out two pieces of Fog cardstock. I'm not sure how many I need, so I was preparing just in case. I'm going to set everything else to the side, and we are going to start out stamping our little images from this stamp set. I am going to be using two of these stamps. I'm going to use the Happy Halloween, which is the sentiment, and this adorable little ghost, which is super cute. And we are going to stamp that out. And I am not going to be using my Misti today. I thought it would just be fun to just stamp using an acrylic block like I used to always do. So we are going to add our happy Halloween, I almost said happy birthday, our happy Halloween sentiment to our block. And then I am going to ink this up in Memento Tuxedo Black ink because I am going to be using my alcohol markers to color this in. So we're gonna get that all nice and stamped up, and I am going to stamp that right across the top here. And we'll take that off there. I'll clean that up later. And then I'm gonna stamp out my little ghost a couple of times because I think we're gonna use a couple. Just stuck my finger right in that ink. It's been so long since I've used an acrylic block that I forget how to use it. So we're gonna stamp out our ghost a couple of times here. Oh, he is just adorable. Isn't he cute? So we're gonna two and maybe one more. Or maybe we'll do an extra one. We'll do four. I know I won't use four, but I am coloring, so I might want to be safe and have an extra one. Okay, so this is not alcohol-friendly cardstock. It is just a regular cardstock. I usually use Express-It white cardstock when I am coloring, but we are going to go nice and slow and color in our little ghosts and our happy Halloween and try not to bleed our color out side of the lines if we can help it. For my ghosts, I'm just going to do really simple coloring. And again, this is on fog cardstock, so the color is going to dry a little bit differently once it's all done. But I am just going to color in my cheeks here of my ghost with OR 2.1 in the Olo markers. And then I want to have a little bit of a kind of a shading or shadow on my ghost. So I am using BG 7.0 and I am just going to highlight one side of our ghost. I'm just gonna run my marker down the side and even around the tail, and that's it. This is gonna dry back and look so much different once it's done because I did kind of play around with the colors before I started filming just to see what I liked and what would look good on these ghosts. But once they dry, you barely even see that shadow, but it is there. So we just have our little last ghost right here that we're going to fill in. Just like that. So you can see the first one that I already did is already starting to blend in already. And even though they're not the smoothest of coloring, like I said, you're barely going to see them once they're dried back. So I am going to now play with coloring in our Happy Halloween. And I'm going to set some music to this because I have to go really slow just in case I go out of the lines. But I will tell you what colors I'm going to use. I'm going to use warm gray, 7, 5, 7, and 9. And then for our candy corns, I'm using, I think I might come in with this one, the 2.1, which is what I used for the cheeks on the tops, and then do two other colors for the bottom, which is going to be 4.4 and 3.4, or maybe 7.6. I think it's going to be 4.4 and 3.4. So let's go ahead. I'm going to turn on a little bit of music and let that play while I slowly do my coloring. First one came out, so I redid it, stamped it. I did it off camera because it was tedious coloring and you really need to take my time. Plus, I found that if my head was directly over my stamped image, I kind of did a little bit of a better job, but I do still see that the color kind of bleeds out. It's not, again, I'm not using cardstock that's meant to be used with Olo markers, but you know, we need to test the waters. So we are going to be using the dyes that coordinate with this stamp set. Let's see here. I'm going to use the little ghost, and we have our Happy Halloween. I think that's it. So we're gonna die cut using these. So for my Happy Halloween, I'm just gonna grab my scissors and we are going to cut this down, and then I could stick my scrap in my little scrap bin because we're not gonna use that anymore. So we'll die cut this. And I'm going to die cut on my little sidekick here today. Tape this into place. This suction down to my countertop here. And then we could just run this right through my machine. Perfect. So we have that. And then we can work on our little ghosts. And I'm just going to cut those out. Really do think I only need three. So we'll stick that here. And again, I'll tape this into place and run this through my sidekick. I love this little sidekick for doing just these little tiny die cuts. It comes in handy. I don't have to bring out my big machine, but now that I'm thinking about it, I'm still going to need my big machine because I have other die cutting I'm going to do. Right, so I have one of our little ghosts. I'm going to go ahead and die cut the other two. So there's one of them. So cute. And then I just have to do my last little ghosty. So cute. All right, so we're gonna run this through. This die set also has, the coordinating dies also have little bats in here, which you can stamp out, but I am just going to die cut them and that's it. We're not gonna stamp them out. And I'm gonna use some black glitter cardstock to stamp them out. In my last card, I did little glitter bats, and I feel like bats should be glittery. I don't know why, but I think it just adds a little shine and pop to our card. So we're going to cut this out maybe 3 times for each of them, just to see. I don't know how many we're going to need, but we are going to put them on our card front. And then just to keep everything together, I'm just going to put everything inside this little tray so I don't lose anything, because I already drop in some of these bats. Got my little pieces all cut there. So we're going to set that aside because we are going to do some more die cutting now. So we're going to bring in our cardstock. I have my card base, my 2 pieces of pattern paper, our peach paper, and our stitched dies. So I am going to pull out these stitched dies because I am going to create a frame. I think I'm going to grab these too. Yeah. So we're going to create a frame just using the largest die and the next larger die. So we have 2. And we are going to tape those down and we'll run that through our die cutting machine. Okay, so that's all set. Then I'm also going to be die cutting. I don't think I need to die cut that. I'm going to die cut these 2 pieces, and I also want them to have a frame. So this piece I need to cut down to 4.25 by 5.5. So it's the same size as my card. And then I'm going to use the smaller size and die cut and try to die cut through both my card front and my piece of pattern paper at the same time to create a window. So we're going to first go ahead. I'm going to go run this through my die cutting machine first. So then I end up with this little frame here that I can use. And then what I'm going to do is take, I'm trying to make sure I have this thought out correctly. I am going to take this piece of cardstock and cut this down to 4.25 by 5.5. So then that makes that the same size as our card front. I'm just going to grab a piece of this tacky tape and put that around my card front just to hold that pattern paper in place so it doesn't shift. And then I'm going to die cut this smaller frame right in the center of that card. So that didn't cut through both of them, but it left me at least enough of a guide that I can put this back in place and run this through my machine one more time. So we just need to kind of feel the grooves, make sure it's in that space, and then I can run it again. I didn't think it would go through both of them, but it was worth a shot, right? I'm going to take this piece that I cut down originally to make the frame. I'm going to glue that down to my card front. Now, I did get a little tear here from my tape. Even though I used a piece of tape that I had used before, it still tore up my pattern paper a little bit, but that's okay. We'll hide that little error. If you saw my last video, I showed you all different ways to use acetate, and for this card, I am going to make a little bit of a floating window so that I can float some of my images onto this acetate. So I am going to actually adhere this down to my piece of pattern paper, and I'm just using some score tape just around the outside of this frame, or the inside of the frame. I don't know how you want to describe it, but it's right around the edge of the frame. And we're just going to get that all on there, and then we can adhere this down to our card front. But using the score tape was actually going to help us keep that acetate in place. Not that I'm making it into a shaker, but it'll at least help hold it in place. I don't have to worry about it falling apart when I'm mailing it or whatever I decide to do with it. Okay, so we're just going to take this piece of acetate and put that right over this piece of pattern paper. Kind of gives it a little bit more support, probably a little bit easier to adhere this down onto my card front. So we are going to now add some more of that double-sided adhesive to the back of this piece here. I'm going to take this piece and we are going to line that up for the front of our card. I'm a little worried I'm not going to hit it right. Let's do it this way. So we're going to line this up right onto the front of that, and we are then blocking that panel right like that. So, and now I'm going to layer that frame. So some of that little tear that I had here does get hidden a little bit, but not a whole bunch. So we're just going to wing that. And instead of going and risking it with the score tape, I am going to use my liquid adhesive to put this one down since it's paper to paper. So my frame that I die cut is going to go also right on the front. Making sure we're nice and straight there. So now I just need to decide, because I think once I put my pattern paper, if I'm going to attach it to the front so it kind of is just loose in the back, or if I'm going to attach it to the back. Now if I attach it to the back of the inside of my card, and then I have my die cuts in the front, I'm going to have no place to write on the inside because you're going to see through it. And then I also have to worry about the back side of everything and then glue everything to the back. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut this down to be 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. Now I did cut this down to 4 1/4 by 5 1/2, but then I went back and just took a little tiny bit off because it's going on the inside. I didn't want that black spiderweb sticking through, but oh my goodness, I'm loving this already. So we're going to take, let's do the double-sided tape again. And we're gonna put it up on the back of the inside front, on the back of the front side of the card. And then we'll take this backing off. And then what I'm gonna do is take my pattern paper, just make sure it's in the inside of my card, and then I'm just gonna close it. So that pattern paper kind of is floating in there as well. I could go ahead and glue the whole thing down, but since I use the double-sided tape, it's gonna stay in there just fine, so I don't have to really do that. What I should have done was paid attention to the pattern on the back. It's just like fabric and sewing, but my pumpkins are upside down on the inside of my card, but that's okay. Just keep that in mind if you try to replicate this card and you're using a double-sided pattern paper, just to make sure if you're going to do it the way I did it, that you make your pattern paper facing in the right direction. So we're just going to add some foam adhesive to the back of our happy birthday, or happy Halloween, not happy birthday. We're going to stick that all in the back there. And that is going to go covering my boo-boo right on the side over here. Just like that. Making sure that we're nice and straight. Cute, cute, cute. And then I'm going to fill in my ghosts. One's going to be floating in the center. We're going to have one on the sides. And then we have our little bats to fill in. So I'm going to go ahead and adhere those down. I do think I am going to pop these up as well. So I'll grab some foam adhesive for these. So I'm going to put one right over on the side here. I'm One in the center, and then another one on the other side. So I just need to place my bats, and one of them is going to help cover up the little mess that I made with the alcohol ink. And we'll just get these guys all in place. So cute. Before the bat dry in the corner, I decided to take that off there and I need to add some twine because I love adding little twine to all of my cards when I can. So I'm going to take this twine and put it in between the two layers. So it's good that I did not tape that fully down. And we are going to wrap this around a couple of times. So I'm going to tie a bow just in the center of this. And if you need a third hand, sometimes you need an extra hand to hold your stuff in place. Just grab your tweezers and grab at the knot, and that'll hold it for you. So we're just going to tie a bow right there at the top. Perfect. Adds a little texture. We can trim this off. And then I'm just going to grab this last bat and add a little bit of adhesive to the center. And then that's my original bat. I'm going to put this right in the center of that bow. Just like that. So cute. If I can get everything kind of in its place. And just while everything dries, I am going to throw an acrylic block on the top just to kind of keep everything in place while everything dries. And that is my card for today. I hope you enjoyed it. I had a lot of fun putting all of the layers together, and it was kind of a little bit of a puzzle trying to figure out how to put this together so we still had a place to write on the inside of our card. Thanks everybody for watching, and I will see you all in the next video. Thanks for watching today's video. If you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you can be notified whenever I post new videos. As always, the list of supplies that I used in today's video are down below in the YouTube description. See you next time!